tell you it was good enough for the gold medal. I've had 1,000 phone calls telling me that Ireland still can win the Triple Crown. Of course they can, despite losing against France today. A bit of cloud passing across the brain. Barry Davis phoned. He's not working today. Dennis Toohey phoned, ex-BBC man. Glad you're still watching the Beeb, Dennis. And now, final score. Here's the Vidi printer, and the score's going through. Newcastle 3, Coventry 2, Alloa 1, Montrose 1 above it. Ipswich have beaten Liverpool 2-1. Hibs 4, Motherwell 0. Walsall 6, Reading 0. Has the Reading bubble burst, one wonders? Gola League 2-1 to Telford against Boston. Division 4, Hartlepool 3, Burnley 1. Scottish 1, Brechin 1, Falkirk 1. Arsenal have beaten Luton by 2-1. Rick's got the winner there. Scottish 2, Stenhouse Muir 2, and Raith 0. So those are the early scores going through. Liverpool lost their chance to go top. Everton and Chelsea, have they taken it? United play tomorrow, of course. That's Manchester United. Division 2, Sheffield United 3, Brighton 0. Brighton with, I think, 4 away victories before that, losing fairly comprehensively today. Scottish Premier Dundee 1, Celtic 3. Mo Johnson amongst the scorers, Celtic in third spot. Scottish 2, Stranraer 0, Albion 2. And Division 2, Millwall 2, Shrewsbury 0. Millwall, after their good cup win against Villa, going well in the league today. The Irish Cup, we don't normally see that, but you'll be happy if you're a Glentoran fan to know that they've beaten Distillery 3-1. Chelsea have drawn with Leicester 2-2. A Linex penalty gave Leicester the equalising goal there. So Chelsea won't go top, but Everton still could. They were 1-up Everton the last we heard. Division 3, Wolverhampton, the bottom club, 0, Bolton 2. Scottish 1 now, Partick 2, Ayr 2. 5 score draws, Scottish 2, Berwick 3, St Johnstone 1. Division 3 now, Plymouth 2, Brentford 0. Those on the same number of points at start of play. Plymouth lost their way a bit in recent weeks, but 3 points today. North of the border, it's Clydebank 1, Hearts 1. Hearts were the leaders there and had to come back. They were a goal to nil down. David Shanks had scored for Clydebank and they played much of the second half with 10 men, so that was a good performance by them, but Hearts came back for a point. Scottish 1, Hamilton 3, Clyde 0. Hamilton, the top club in that division, leaders by 4 points. Division 2, Leeds 4, Stoke 0. And Nobby Stiles' son, John Stiles, got at least one of the Leeds goals, I think making his debut today. Division 4, Wrexham 1, Mansfield 2, Mansfield in third spot, and Wrexham lose. No, it's not Wrexham. I thought they were unbeaten at home, but they're not. But a good win for Mansfield in third place. Division 2, Portsmouth 4, Huddersfield 1. Tate started them on their way. Dillon got a penalty, I know. Portsmouth in second spot, and well clear of the third place club, Wimbledon, who haven't played today. Their match was postponed. Division 2, Oldham 2, Sunderland 2. And Division 1, Chelsea 2, Leicester 2 is confirmed. And Division 4, Aldershot 2, Cambridge 1. Now Division 3, Doncaster 1, Lincoln 1. Lincoln with very few away points, getting one at the fifth place club. Division 1, Oxford United 0, Birmingham 1. Well, John Bond has just taken over and he's got them their first win in 18 games. Wayne Clark, the scorer. Division 4, Northampton 0, Swindon 1. Swindon in second place. Henry, I believe, got their goal this afternoon for Swindon. Chester are the leading club. They were winning 2 the last I saw. Division 4, Torquay 1, Preston 0. They're the bottom 2. And in fact, the bottom club beating the second bottom there in Division 4. Division 4, Hereford 0, Chester 2. Chester will indeed stay top. Tough winning at Hereford, but they've managed to do it. And I hear that Everton have beaten Tottenham, and the goal scorer, would you believe, Peter Reid, back in business today for the first time this season. Splendid afternoon for him. That, of course, a rehearsal for the cup tie in 2 weeks' time, which will be played at White Hart Lane. But Everton winning on home ground today, 1-0. And if my mathematics are right, Everton will be top of the league tonight. Right, well, Harry Gratian has been watching that match. Let's hear how Everton got that victory. Harry, it's all yours. Here he is.
As a dream goal after a 5-month layoff by Peter Reid gave Everton a vital win just 8 minutes from time. Up to that point, it looked a certain draw, with Spurs offering not one shot on goal in 90 minutes, but defending well. Everton, by their own high standards, didn't play well, but Reid warmed the heart of 33,000 fans with his 18-yard shot, which hit the underside of the bar and bounced over the line, beating Clemens. As for Spurs, well, they offered so little. Miller was booked in the first half, and there was only ever one side who looked likely to score. And for Reed, that's a moment he's waited and longed for since his last game in August 1985. Everton 1, Spurs 0.
A less happy day for Liverpool. They haven't had a good time at Portman Road in recent seasons, and they lost their 2-1 today, watched by Gerald Sinstad.
You couldn't imagine conditions more unpleasant than they were here. A bitter wind driving torrential rain down the ground throughout. And yet we had a passionate match, remarkable for its quality. Ipswich with Brennan and Zondervan impressively influential in midfield, Butcher and Cranson magnificent battlers at the back, came from behind to win deservedly. Liverpool without Ian Rush had Craig Johnson up front, Mulvey sweeping, and the back four all capable of coming forward. Whelan gave them the lead, heading in Mulvey's free kick. But in the second half, Davray stole the equaliser, and when Nichols' header went astray, Wilson lashed in the winner. It was a fine game, but by golly, Desmond, I hope it's warmer in Mexico.
You can be sure of that. Right, Chelsea were the other club which had a chance of going top today. They just failed to do it. They were held 2-2 at home by Leicester. David Davis reporting now.
A frolic in the mud that left Chelsea frustrated, but frankly this was a lottery of a match that they might even have lost. Leicester, especially Alan Smith, I thought, ploughing through the mud with the more conviction early on, but Duncan Shearer on his debut, taking his goal on the turn with a style they'd have relished in the Highlands at his old club Inverness, Clachnacuddin. Chelsea, you thought, were on their way, but Mochlin made it 1-1 after the unhappy Dublin lost possession. Substitute Keith Jones restored the Chelsea lead with a header, only for the Chelsea captain Pates to foul Seeley, and Linex squeezed home the penalty. Three times Chelsea defenders cleared off the line. The rain came down, the legs got heavier, the mud got even deeper, and Chelsea's hopes of the First Division leadership disappeared into it.
So Everton will be top. We're just collating the classified results for you. Let me just tell you in the meantime that as far as cricket is concerned, in Colombo, Sri Lanka beat England B by 4 wickets in the one-day match. England B made 162 for 8 in 45 overs. Sri Lanka 163 for 6 in 41.3 overs. And athletics, there's been high wind and rain everywhere. And Zola Budd braved them. And biting cold as well, to win the Southern Counties Cross Country Championship at Peterborough today. Right, you saw me glancing there to see if the classified results were ready. I can see that they are. Here they come.
League Division 1. Arsenal 2, Luton Town 1. Aston Villa 0, Southampton 0. Chelsea 2, Leicester City 2. Everton 1, Tottenham Hotspur 0. Ipswich Town 2, Liverpool 1. Manchester City 2, West Bromwich Albion 1. Newcastle United 3, Coventry City 2. Nottingham Forest 4, Queen's Park Rangers 0. Oxford United 0, Birmingham City 1. Watford 2, Sheffield Wednesday 1. West Ham United and Manchester United, that's a Sunday game. League Division 2. Barnsley 2, Norwich City 2. Blackburn Rovers 2, Hull City 2. Bradford City against Wimbledon, match postponed. Crystal Palace 1, Carlisle United 1. Grimsby Town against Fulham, late kickoff. Leeds United 4, Stoke City 0. Middlesbrough 1, Charlton Athletic 3. Millwall 2, Shrewsbury Town 0. Oldham Athletic 2, Sunderland 2, Portsmouth 4, Huddersfield Town 1, Sheffield United 3, Brighton and Hove Albion 0. And League Division 3, Blackpool 0, Derby County 1, Bristol Rovers 2, Newport County 0, Bury against Darlington, late kickoff, Doncaster Rovers 1, Lincoln City 1, Gillingham 4, Notts County 0, Plymouth Argyle 2, Brentford 0, Rotherham United 4, Swansea City 1, Walsall 6, Reading 0, Wigan Athletic 1, Bristol City 1, Wolverhampton Wanderers 0, Bolton Wanderers 2, League Division 4, Aldershot 2, Cambridge United 1. Hartlepool United 3, Burnley 1. Hereford United 0, Chester City 2. Northampton Town, 0. Swindon Town, 1. Peterborough United against Rochdale, match postponed. Port Vale, 2. Orient, 0. Torquay United, 1. Preston North End, 0. Wrexham, 1. Mansfield Town, 2. The Finefair Scottish League Premier Division, Clydebank 1, Heart of Midlothian 1, Dundee 1, Celtic 3, Hibernian 4, Motherwell 0, Rangers 1, Aberdeen 1, St Mirren 1, Dundee United 1. Scottish League Division 1, Aerionians 1, Morton 2, Alloa 1, Montrose 1, Brecon City 1, Falkirk 1, East Fife 2, Kilmarnock 2, Forfar Athletic 4, Dumbarton 0, Hamilton Academicals 3, Clyde 0, Partick Thistle 2, Ayr United 2, Scottish League Division 2, Arbroath 2, Queen of the South 2, Berwick Rangers 3, St Johnstone 1, Dunfermline Athletic 2, Stirling Albion 3, East Stirlingshire 2, Cowdenbeath 1, Meadowbank Thistle 2, Queen's Park 1, Stenhouse Muir 2, Raith Rovers 0, Stranraer 0, Albion Rovers 2. The Vauxhall Opal League Premier Division, Harrowborough 3, Bognor Regis Town 2, Slough Town 2, Farnborough Town 3, Worthing 0, Hendon 2, and Yeovil Town against Walthamstow Avenue is a late kickoff.
And another couple of scores that we need. Grimsby Town have beaten Fulham 1-0 in the second division. Bury 0, Darlington 1 is a latest kickoff. And in the Vauxhall League, Yeovil Town 0, Walthamstow is a latest, with Walthamstow 1-0 up. Walthamstow. Right. Here's the top of the first division, and there's a sight you haven't seen so far this season. Manchester United displaced for the first time this season. They're playing tomorrow, of course, and might well regain top place. But Everton are the new leaders. The champions are back on top. Peter Reid did the business for them today, back in the team, and scoring their only goal in the match against Tottenham. Chelsea held 2-2 at home. Liverpool lost their chance, losing 2-1 away at Portman Road at Ipswich. That's the top of Division 1 as it looks right now. Here's the bottom. West Bromwich Albion well adrift. Birmingham City got their first win in 18 matches today since September the 21st. John Bond, back in business, of course, and Alan Clark got the vital goal against Oxford, the club above them. So perhaps their renaissance is beginning. Top of two is like this. Norwich City were held today for the first time in 11 games. They drew away. Portsmouth won handsomely at home. There's now just 3 points between them. Charlton go third. They won as well. A good away victory for them today. And Wimbledon didn't play. Sheffield United go fifth in place of Brighton, the team that they beat today. Bottom positions are like this. Carlisle adrift. Fulham above them. Middlesbrough beaten at home. And Huddersfield beaten away. Top of three. Has the Reading bubble burst, beaten at home by Bury in the Cup, and now thrashed 6 goals at Walsall today. But there's still those amazing 14 points clear at the top of Gillingham, who beat Notts County and stay second, and Notts County move from third to sixth. Derby, of course, have got plenty of games in hand. And the bottom of Division 3, quick look, because I haven't looked at it recently, Wolves a point adrift at the bottom. Darlington, Swansea and Lincoln, those four clubs are the ones in the danger positions at the moment. Top of four, and Chester and Swindon, Mansfield and Hartlepool, the top four, certainly all won today, and those are the four clubs in the promotion positions at the moment. Right, let's move north of the border now, where I think amongst the top teams only Celtic won today, Archie.
Correct. You're magnificent with these statistics. And can I say that the jam tarts, as we've been calling them recently, were more like cream buns today when they struggled against 10 men. Given of Clyde Bank was sent off just after the start of the second half, and then they scored. So Hearts laboured after that against these 10 men and only scored the equaliser with 3 minutes left through Sandy Clark, with David Shanks having scored that early goal by Clyde Bank. And you're right. Celtic were the only team of the top contenders who won today. There were one goal down through Ray Stephen. He scored from a penalty kick early on in the match. Paul McStay actually missed a penalty kick. Mo Johnson, though, he's in the goals again. He got the equaliser. Then McStay scored the second, and eventually McClare. And the United, well, they're still going strong. We might have thought that they would have won today at Love Street, but they haven't got a good record down there. They haven't won in the last six visits, although Paul Hegarty put them in the lead in the 50th minute, and Rooney equalised in the 57th minute. And Rangers, they were a goal down to Aberdeen in exactly 2 minutes today when Joe Miller scored, but Hugh Burns, the fullback, equalised just after the start of the second half. And poor Motherwell, oh dear, lamentations. They're way at the foot of the table there. Hibs beating them easily today, 4-0. Cowan got a couple, Collins and Forbes an own goal. And in the first division, well, Hamilton are still going very strongly there. Absolutely one of the favourite teams of many people in the south. They won by 3-0 today. They're 5 points clear. They stay at the top and unbeaten in the last 11 games, with 4-4 moving into third place as a result of that 4-goal win over Dumbarton. And they've won only 2 wins in the last 11 games. And in the second division, it's going to be extremely close today, but you can see that Queen of the South just got there, just in front today, and they're 1 point in the lead. And I think, nevertheless, that these two top teams will be promoted, Des.
You're nearly always right, Archie. Thanks very much indeed. Well, let's switch from soccer for the moment, because we're still waiting for the pools information, and we'll go to Rugby Union and give you the results there.
International matches, France 29 points, Ireland 9, Wales 22, Scotland 15. In the John Player Special Cup, third round, Broughton Park 12, Vale of Lune 6, Gosforth 6, Northampton 6. Northampton qualify for the next round. John Smith's merit table, A, Leicester 24, London Scottish 0, and the B table, Coventry 16, Waterloo 4. The club matches, Bradford 16, Nuneaton 7, Cambridge University 19, the Army 10, Cheltenham 14, Exeter 4, Durham 32, Huddersfield 0. Vale 3, Gala 9. Glamorgan Wanderers 58, Torquay 4. Glasgow Academicians 14, Stuart and Melrose former pupils 38. Metropolitan Police 22, Harlequins 17. Middlesbrough 0, Kelso 33. Northern 3, Nottingham 17. Richmond 0, Headingley 8. Sale 34, Liverpool 15. Saracens 23, Birmingham 10. Sheffield 37, Manchester 0. Wakefield 15, Birkenhead Park 7. West Hartlepool 30, New Brighton 6. Western Supermare 7, Rugby 16.
Now, I think we've got the pools news collated, but first we need to give you that result in Division 3. Bury 0, Darlington 1. And in that Premier Division of the Vauxhall Opal, Yeovil Town 2, Walthamstow 1. Which means that the pools information is like this. Well, 15 score draws, 1 no score draw, don't bother ringing up, dividend forecast very low. But here are the score draw numbers. 3, 12, 13, 15, 20, 26, 30 and 43. 46, 47, 49, 50, 51, 54. And 55. None of us will get rich this week, which means I'll be back here next week. Now, one or two racing results for you.
Sandown 3:35. First number 1 Berlin 5-2. Second number 2 Desert Orchid 11-10 on favourite. Third number 4 All 10 Glazed 7-1. And the 4-5 at Sandown won by number 11 Brunico 5-2. Second number 14 Emir Sultan 16-1. Third number 2 Billion Boy 25-1. Stratford 3:45, first number 16 Winart 12-1, second number 10 Mary Jane 11-8 favourite, third number 1 Winter Measure 11-2.
Even if I won the pools, I'd still be back here next week, I think, if they asked me. Now it's time for the closing headlines. In rugby, Welsh fullback Paul Thorburn kicks 5 penalties, including that monster, as Wales beat Scotland 22-15 at Cardiff. Paris, last year's champions, Ireland are crushed 29-9 by France. The flamboyant French score three tries, one of them like this. And those results mean four countries now have 2 points, and only the champions, Ireland, are without a point. Snooker and defending champion Cliff Thorburn and Tony Knowles are level at three frames all in their semi-final of the Benson and Hedges Masters at Wembley. It's first to six, remember. You'll see it later on too. Racing and the favourite for this year's Gold Cup and Grand National, Burrahill Lad puts a smile back on trainer Jenny Pittman's face as he storms to victory at Sandown today. Ice dancing, and for Torvill and Dean these days, read Beste Manöver, if you can, and Bukin, their tops in Europe again. And in football, Peter Reid returns as a winner. After an absence of 5 months, he scores Everton's winner against Spurs to put the champions back on top of Division One for the first time this season. And Bond is back. John, that is. His new club, Birmingham, were shaken but not stirred. They win at Oxford, their first league victory since September. Kevin Wilson hits a late winner for Ipswich in their 2-1 win over Liverpool. Duncan Shearer scores on his debut for Chelsea, but Leicester go home with a point after a 2-2 draw. And finally, the name Stiles is back in football. John Stiles, son of Nobby, gets one as Leeds win 4-0. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.